Red Chair Diaries. I want to say a few words about the death of Eddie Fisher, or perhaps I should better say the life of Eddie Fisher. Once again, I come from the mindset of somebody who remembers when Eddie Fisher left Debbie Reynolds for Elizabeth Taylor. I mean, I was very young, you know, 9 or 10, but it was so much part of what we now call the zeitgeist that without all of the instant communications that we have now, I think at that point we might have only had one satellite in orbit, I mean, North America-wise, to even communicate across the globe. But there was not a bigger story. I mean, possibly it was bigger than the Cuban Missile Crisis. And when people talk about Brangelina, you know, Brad and Angelina, and how they started their affair during Mr. and Mrs. Jones, and, you know, Angelina stealing Brad from Jennifer Aniston, etc. That was all done, for those of us who are older, when Elizabeth Taylor put her hooks into Eddie Fisher. And when Debbie Reynolds, I think, sent Eddie Fisher over, who was also a friend of Liz's husband, Mike Todd, who died in a plane crash, when he was out, I think, promoting around the world in 80 days. And he went over, and things developed over the course of, I guess, a few weeks or whatever. I'm not quite sure in the time period. But, wow, that was the biggest scandal in the world. And, I'm telling you, in the world. And Debbie Reynolds was considered America's sweetheart. Whether that's true or not, you know, it most likely isn't. I mean, as far as, you know, her own behavior. But Eddie, the father of Carrie Fisher and Jolie Fisher, boy, was he hated in the States for that. And then Liz dumped him shortly afterwards because on the set of Cleopatra, she fell in love with Richard Burton. So that's the thing, the scandal went on for years in the press. But of course, a lot of the juicy details didn't come out for years later because the press, I don't think, was quite as lascivious then as it is now. Anyway, that's something that guys in their 20s, gay guys in their 20s, might want to do a little bit of research on. Liz Taylor is like the merry widow, and I love Liz, don't get me wrong. I love Liz. That she's outliving all of her husbands. I think John Warner, the senator that she was involved in the mid-70s, I think he's alive. And her young fellow, Larry Fratensky, I think he was the 80s. He's still living, I believe, and I think he's probably in his 50s now, maybe even in his 60s. Liz is about 77 or 80 or something, I think, something like that. Anyway, Eddie Fisher behaved badly, but millions of men and women do. And, you know, then he had his problems with the cocaine and all of that stuff and the succession of other wives, things like that. But, you know, he had a big career. And he was a big sort of Las Vegas singer, lounge singer, and had a lot of hits. And, you know, he shouldn't just be written off as a joke or something, as a footnote. I mean, he was a person, obviously. He was a father. He had feelings and all of that sort of stuff. And just circumstances, you know. That's, I guess, how these things go. I don't really know. I think I've been mostly 99.99.99% loyal, so. Anyway, that's about it for now. Michael from the Red Chair Diaries. Look him up, Eddie Fisher.